Hey everybody, welcome back to the Kel-n-rich show. My name is Kel, and this is my awesome husband, Rich.
Thanks, Kel. Welcome, you guys. Thanks for being here. We've been away for a little while.
Yeah, we've had...
The internet, our fiber optic, was screwed up, and it's been screwed up for a little while, and it was really screwed up, so...
The whole wire and line is deteriorated.
The feed, actually, to the house.
They're putting a whole new one in with, like... backhoes and ripping up the lawn.
The backhoes was that was interesting, and it was just like, whoa, that's why we're down. So sorry about that. And we can't upload these videos in like a Starbucks or anything because they're quite large and it would just take like 3 days. So we'd be like, another venti,
we
please.
Can't transfer them to our phones because
anyway, so that's where we've been. So it's not for a lack of trying. So something special for you tonight, Kel. Now yes, it is Monday, and we will be doing a prog song.
Oh, good.
Okay. But this one's been on the chart for a while. When we did Has Kel Heard This Song? We looked in the sparkly notebook, and I said, oh, my God, Paradise by the Dashboard Light. She hasn't heard her. She said, well, maybe. I think maybe.
By the Dashboard Light? Light. Is the Dashboard Light is the band? Paradise?
Paradise by the Dashboard Light is a song by Meatloaf.
Oh, Meatloaf.
Meatloaf.
Right.
So... and I remember you had some beef about Meatloaf. I had to say that. sorry. You just had something about it. But I read an article today. It was almost like a little paragraph.
Well, or not really a paragraph. Explain the Meatloaf.
And I had to play this particular song for you tonight. And okay, let me hear about Meatloaf.
So when I was a little girl growing up, I didn't like the Meatloaf that I was served. And so I felt that it was quite a torturous thing to have to eat this stuff. And then I heard of this guy named Meatloaf who was singing, and just based on the fact that I hated Meatloaf, I didn't want anything to do with his music, nothing. And so I went an entire lifetime refusing to listen to Meatloaf because I...
Yes, and we did do a song from Bad Outta Hell several months ago, way back. So if you do Kel-n-rich, Meatloaf, you'll see.
We did that song, and I loved it. And then you said to me that he's on the Rocky Horror Picture Show, which I also didn't see growing up. You took me. Mm-hmm. And I didn't know we watched it.
Yeah, we watched it. I have it on DVD.
And I didn't know he's that
Eddie.
Was him.
Yeah.
Right? And I thought he was great, and I fell in love with Eddie. Yes. So I'm more than happy to listen to something else
Born
from him.
Born in his mother's side. So there you go.
From?
That's from Rocky Horror. Oh. Yeah. That's from Dr. Everett Scott. Okay, so you guys, you have to stay to after the video, after she has her reaction to Paradise by the Dashboard Light.
Paradise
by Meatloaf. Because I'm gonna read this. Today starts couple goals training, day number one. Okay?
Right.
Relationship goals for everybody out there. Okay, if you have a great relationship and it's just blissful and it's great, fantastic. You can just watch along or whatever. But we have so many questions and so many comments about how good of chemistry we have together that this article deserves a reaction from Kel. So you have to stay after her reaction to the music, and we're going to talk about this. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Cool.
Cool.
So, all right.
Okay. Great.
If you want to make a request for songs, go to the website, okay, and it's on the right-hand side under Make a Request, not under Ask Kel-n-rich. That's if you have a question to ask us can you play Marillion? Can you play Pink Floyd? Can you play whatever? All right, ready, Kel?
I'm ready. This is exciting.
Okay, now.
I love the Bad Out of Hell song.
Yeah, the whole album, I mean, is great. So, yeah, this is just, yeah. So that's where we're getting it from.
Great.
So, Ellen Foley does the original vocals, the duet with Meatloaf, okay?
Okay.
Karla Devito is actually pictured in this video because Ellen, under a problem with the contract, she couldn't tour with Meatloaf and stuff like that. So Karla took over for several years. She toured the world with him and then went on to Broadway and things like that. But this is a lip-synced video because Ellen couldn't show up because of contractual problems to do the video.
Okay.
Okay, a little history.
Contractual problems.
Yeah. Huh. Money.
Right.
All right. I need
not enough M&Ms in the dressing room.
Damn it. Who's in charge here? I said I need M&Ms. Helps with that. I need a sound effect if we're going to do this. It's good, Kel.
This is quiet. All right. It's just demure tonight.
Ready?
I'm ready.
All right. Love that lyric. We're barely 17, we're barely dressed. Baby, don't you hear my heart? You gotta drown it out the radio. I've been waiting so long for you to come along and have some fun. Well, I gotta let you know, no, you're never gonna regret it. So open up your eyes, I got a big surprise. It'll feel alright. Well, I wanna make you more. Slide head first.
Oh, wait, safe, bad, safe. This kid really makes things happen out there. Batter steps up to the plate. Here's the trench, and he's going, and what a jump he's got. He's trying to turn. His throw is in the dirt. Safe, bad, third. Holy cow, stolen base. Taking a pretty big lead out there. Almost daring him to try and pick him off. Pitcher glances over, winds up, and it's fun and fun and down the third baseline. The suicide squeezes on. Here he comes. Squeeze play is going to be close. Here's the throw. Here's the play at the plate. Holy cow, I think he's making it.
Stop right there. I gotta know right now. Before we go any further, love me? Will you love me forever? Do you need
She's giving
me?
Him the gears, man.
Will you never leave me? Will you make me so happy for the rest of my life? Will you take me away? Will you make me away? Do you love me? Will you love me forever? Do you need me? Will you never leave me? Will you make me so happy for the rest of my life? Will you take me away? Will you make me away? I gotta know right now. Before we go any further, do you love me? Will you love me forever?
Let me sleep on it. Baby, baby, let me sleep on it. Let me sleep on it. I'll give you an answer in the morning. Let me sleep on it. Baby, baby, let me sleep on it. Let me sleep on it. I'll give you an answer in the morning. Let me sleep on it. Baby, baby, let me sleep on it. Let me sleep on it. I'll give you an answer in the morning.
I gotta know right now, do you love me? Will you love me forever? Do you need me? Will you never leave me? Will you make me so happy for the rest of my life? Will you take me away? Will you make me your wife? I gotta know right now, before we go any further, do you love me? Will you love me forever?
What pressure.
Come on, I can wait all night. What's it gonna be, boy, yes or no? What's it gonna be, boy, yes or no?
Let me sleep on it. Baby, baby, let me sleep on it.
Well, let me sleep on it.
Best line right here.
So now I'm praying for the end of time. So hurry up and arrive. Cause if I gotta spend another minute with you, I don't think that I can really survive. I'll never break my promise or forget my vow. But God only knows what I can do right now. I'm praying for the end of time. That's all that I can do. Praying for the end of time so I can end my time with you.
Isn't that awful? Isn't that awful? And it was so much better than it is today. That is so cool. Completely opposite, right? It's like, oh, it never felt so good, never felt so right. We were glowing like the men on the edge of it. It was long ago, it was far away, and it was so much better than it is today. Look at her. Look at her. Oh my God.
Okay, that was like super stressful.
Super stressful. Oh. Relationship angst, the pressure. We were barely 17 and we were barely dressed.
And then to turn into that.
Fuck. So what else do you think before I read this to you?
Well, I don't really.
Hopefully you guys are
me.
Still here. Hopefully you didn't leave. This is the best part.
It occurred to me that the reason I have an issue with Meatloaf is because I don't actually understand Meatloaf. So it's not that I don't want to. So the reason I'm going here is because I'm in my learning phase. So you know how some bands have, they have a shtick, you
okay.
know? They have
yeah.
a costume. They have a theme. We know many of them. I'm not sure what he's...
He's Meatloaf, man.
But is he supposed to be as big as a meatloaf?
Well...
he's
without going into this, you guys fill in the story really, about I'm honestly asking, about that. Okay, I will take time. I'm not going to.
I just think he likes to eat. He's not your.
He
typical...
doesn't look like he didn't look like that for too much longer after like the mid '80s.
Because most of the stars that we see are jumping around on stage like that, and they are.
Well, he reminds me of like a Chris. He reminds me of like a Chris Farley, right?
Yes.
Rocking and ripping a piece, right? Well, Chris Farley could do like freaking backflips and cartwheels and stuff. I mean, he was a football player, and I'm not going to get into that with Meatloaf and his.
Well,
his,
but I'm
his
trying
weight.
To understand his character, his shirt, the ruffles, the.
Oh, well, that was just a video that they did. I mean, that was probably, you know what? I don't know.
Just tell me what you all love about him. That will make it really easy. Well, so why don't you tell me what you love about him?
Major hits, great songwriter. You know, I Will Do Anything for Love, But I Won't Do That is a fantastic song.
Oh, I know
song.
That song.
You know that song, great. So many great songs.
I don't like that song. I love the music. I just don't like the subject matter.
Gotcha. Fill us in about what you guys like about Meatloaf. Sorry,
what do you love about him? Just to help me out.
Yeah,
here.
Over the years, and he's still touring. He's still, I believe, let us know. But this was probably 1977, 78. So you're talking about 40 years. So again, another lifetimer.
And I think I need to hear that song again and really focus on the lyrics because I was listening, but the story was quite confusing.
Well, again, everybody, what I don't want to do is I don't want to taint Kel's first experience. I'll have my fun during the songs just because it's a great song and she'll do whatever she's doing. But there's plenty of time for her to learn. There's plenty of time for you to watch the lyrics. You know, you can have it on your phone or have it up on the computer. But they're fantastic lyrics and how, you know, the, oh my God, Phil, anyway, the announcer, mm-hmm. Phil Rizzuto.
I don't know.
Oh God, I'm drawing a blank on his name. The Yankee. How he was the announcer and it was all about comparing, getting to the bases, first base, second base.
I understood
just
that.
Brilliant.
I wasn't sure what the baseball game was about until I put those things together.
So did you like the song?
Yeah, it's tough subject matter. They hated each other by the end, clearly.
Funny you should say that. So here we go. Couple relationship goals, day number one. Okay, Kel, I'm going to read this to you.
Okay.
And you're going to react to it. For couples so eager to call it quits after the infatuation wears off, to throw in the towel on your relationship because everything isn't perfect, here's some food for thought. Lifelong commitment is not what most people think it is. It's not waking up every morning to make breakfast and eat together. It's not cuddling in bed until both of you fall asleep. It's not a clean home filled with laughter and love making every day. Oh, sorry. It's not a clean home filled with laughter and love making every day. Gotta be careful with the punctuation on that one. No, this is what it's not. This is what I'm reading. This is why I'm bringing it up.
Okay.
You know who it is? It's someone who steals all the covers and snores. It's slammed doors and some harsh words at times. It's stubbornly disagreeing and giving each other the silent treatment until your hearts heal, and then offering forgiveness and being forgiven. It's coming home to the same person every day that you know loves and cares about you in spite of and because of who you are. How are we doing so far?
Is this a joke?
This is not a joke. This is actually what... We'll talk about it. I'll read the end. It's about helping each other with the hard work of life. It's about swallowing the nagging words instead of saying them out loud. Remember, it's about swallowing the nagging words. That's what relationships are about.
That's commitment?
That's commitment. It's about eating the easiest meal you can make and sitting down together at a late hour because you both had a crazy day. It's when you have had an emotional breakdown and your love lays down with you and holds you. and tells you everything's going to be okay. So you see that there's kind of two things going on here. There's the, yeah, that makes sense. And then there's the other wacky shit that, and we'll talk about it. We'll see what you say. And you believe them. It's about still loving someone, even though sometimes they make you absolutely insane. I'll read that again. It's about loving someone, even though sometimes they make you absolutely insane. And I don't think insane in a good way. Loving someone isn't always easy. Sometimes it's hard. Loving someone is sometimes hard in a relationship that you're staying in. But it's amazing, comforting, and one of the best things you'll ever experience. Heart. If you're blessed to have a wonderful partner in your life, then copy and paste the above, attach a picture of the two of you, and post it. I want to see a couple pictures of all of my friends, please. So actually, this must have been a copy of a Facebook post or something that someone wrote. And it had all these comments on it and things like that that were like, yeah, you tell them, girl. What's your take on what you just read, Kel? And I can leave it up if you want to talk about specific parts.
After the dashboard song, for me personally, I'll only speak. I can't even believe that people live in an environment where they say they love you and they slam doors and have harsh words. I've already lived in a life like that. And I refuse to raise the people in my life.
To what?
To raise them like their children. People that need to come prepackaged at this point. I've already had 4 decades of a war.
Okay, so.
So no, I do not agree with any of this. Commitment is something we choose. Every day that we wake up, the behavior clock resets to 0, which means that every morning I have to open my eyes and come up with wonderful ways to be a positive force in your life because I want you to want me to be there. And it's always a choice. Even though we're married, we have a standing agreement that if for some reason this is no longer good to you or good for you or good to me and good for me, that we're having a very clear discussion.
So I'll play devil's advocate, okay? So you've made your vows. You've committed just like the song, okay? And now all these things happen. The covers are stolen from you. I'm snoring. There's slamming of doors and harsh words. It's giving you a silent treatment until your heart's healed and offering forgiveness. And people are saying that is what a relationship is. Don't be fooled to thinking that it's perfect. It can't be perfect.
I think that the word perfect needs discussing then, because
sure,
people have an idea of what perfect is, and my idea of perfect is you being perfectly you.
Right.
Not that so you're perfect, that you're you.
So perfect. Oh, my perfect me is I slam doors and I give you the silent treatment and I take the covers away and I do all these other things that this person's saying is just par for the course.
You know what? I would give you, I'm a baseball player. I catch. You get three strikes. So we'd have a conversation, offer counseling, support. I'll be there with you. I might have already been through this already.
So have I. So have I. And that's why I brought this and the song, because
I think that for me, it's not workable. It's absolutely disgusting. It hurts my heart.
Yeah, but you made vows under God and in front of the family, in front of everyone. And it's your religion.
I'm allowed to make mistakes. And I've made many, 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 many mistakes. And I have more yet to make.
So I'll read the very beginning, the first line. For couples so eager to call it quits after the infatuation wears off, to throw in the towel in your relationship because everything isn't perfect. Here's some food for thought.
I can't listen to it so anymore.
Basically, yeah, it's making me a little chunky too.
Yeah, I can't hear those words.
You know what it is? It's freaking acquiescing and playing so small, not having the balls to say, you know what, this relationship, it's not going anywhere. Yep, we've raised some kids. Yep, we've been together for 16 years. Yep, we've been together for 25 years, 35 years, whatever. And this just doesn't work for me and I'm looking for a better life.
I know a man and he's 84 and he just divorced his wife. He said that it was enough and that 60 years was more than his fair share.
Yeah, and maybe some people out there are saying, wait a second, Kel-n-rich are advocating people leaving their marriages, leaving children, everything like that. No, we're not saying that.
No.
We're saying that if you've been living with this for this long, maybe it's time to have an honest assessment. And if you are, you know, so the song goes, the lyrics go, I'll never break my promise or forget my vows, but God only knows what I can do right now. I'm praying for the end of time so I can end my time with you. Can you imagine living like that? And people are doing it all the time. And when I read this crap, it was like, who are children being taught this? Is watching mom and dad slug it out and do it, and that's considered, you know, that's what relationships are? Bullshit. Yeah. Bullshit. That's two chicken shits not having the balls to call it. Or it's a religious thing and say, you know what? Commitment to God, commitment to Christ before, commitment to whatever comes before my personal needs.
And, you know, to each their own, we're never, ever trying to tell anybody
what
to do. Not at all.
This is not advice. This is
between a discussion between us. Absolutely. If you started behaving one shred of that, there'd be a discussion, and then that's it. I would insist that you get counseling. If you didn't choose to do that, I would mark an X on the calendar, and then I would leave. And I would never come back.
And people, okay, here's the other part of this. So people, a relationship is
I've done it.
So there's a relationship, and then one of the partners loses their job. Their favorite goldfish passes away. They're in a car accident, and they're messed up, and they are just out of sorts. Right?
Well, I think you would take every situation into consideration.
Of course.
In my particular situation, I was with somebody who became exceptionally abusive. Oh, thank you. And I won't stand for that. And so I gave my terms.
Yep.
I gave time. I offered solutions. It didn't work. And I put an X on the calendar. And that was the day that I left. And he knew that that was going to happen.
Yep. And I did the same thing. I said, you know what? This is no longer a place for me to be. She was abusive. She was a narcissist. She ended up basically firing all that stuff back at me. Complete and utter BS. And then I realized, holy cow, I need to leave. And you know what she did? At that point, she did all the behavior, the I want something from you behavior, the model behavior, everything that I wanted over the years, saying she started doing it.
Yeah.
And I was like, wow, this is actually pretty cool. Until the effect wore off. And it was like Jekyll and Hyde. Boom. She snapped right back into it. Because it wasn't her. We weren't a good match. And that's the point of that this song, right? There's two hot 17-year-olds, right? Getting it on. Paradise by the Dashboard Light, right?
Oh.
So they're, you know, getting it on. And, you know, he had to make some promises, you know. Will you love me forever? You know, let me sleep on it. Baby, let me sleep on it. Let me sleep on it. I'll give you my answer in the morning.
Right.
And she said, I got to know right now. Do you love me? Will you love me forever? Do you need me? Will you never leave me? Will you make me so happy for the rest of my life? Will you take me away? Will you make me your wife? I got to know right now. And he's like, And then he says, I couldn't take it any longer. God, I was crazy, man. And the feeling came upon me like a tidal wave. And on my mother's grave that I would love you till the end of time. I swore that I'd love you till the end of time. And now I'm praying for the end of time, so hurry up and arrive. Because if I have to spend another minute with you, I don't think that I can barely survive. I'll never break my promise or forget my vows, but God only knows what I can do right now.
How many times have you heard this song?
Enough to remember it. And I remember listening to the song kind of toward the end of when I realized, oh my God, I need to get out of this relationship. And I'm going to do my best to make it so that the kids are as good as possible. But I will not continue to be in this shitty relationship and thinking that it's all me. And so I was him at the end of the song. And I'm going, no way am I going to spend this precious existence that we have mm-hmm. with someone that is not a good match for me. She might be a good person to other people, whatever, but to me, she was a lunatic. She's a lunatic. And it was, it always had to be about her. And in the song, it was kind of like, he made a promise, and then he was just, he was being strict to the promise. And I just think, wow, imagine that life.
Well, you had that life, and I had that
life. I did have that life until I said no more.
So many of you out there have had those lives.
Yeah, some of you are going through this where you're breaking up, or you've been broken up with, and it hurts. It's an uncoupling, right? It's a new word, mm-hmm. decoupling.
And the celebrities. You know, part of this here that you're seeing, falling in love with each other was a complete surprise. I've said it before on the channel. I expected to just grow old and be a crazy cat lady by myself.
Yeah, I was
going to
be single after my relationship.
I was done.
I was like, no, you know, apparently I'm not cut out for this or whatever.
And we have a lot of we have rules about how we behave with each other. If I'm not your biggest cheerleader, mm-hmm. then there's a serious problem. And if you are not my greatest champion in my life, I got the wrong guy.
Yes.
And I don't need saving, and you don't need cheering.
Yeah. So what it is,
but it's about being good to people and good for people.
Yeah. And I guess that's the message. If you're out there and you're single and you want someone to be your, you know, your couple, okay, your coupling, just be yourself. Someone's going to find you for who you are. And when you find that person, you know, there's going to be some testing, I would imagine. But it's pretty clear when you two are digging on each other, and it's not just the sexual thing and not just the hot and heavy or whatever she describes it as, the infatuation, or she says when the infatuation wears off, you know, no, you don't throw in the towel after that. But why would the infatuation wear off? Why? No.
Why would you not always be crushing on me? Because I'm always going to be crushing on you, even when we're 85.
Me crushing on her is not about her, and not the way that she looks or the way she smells or the way she talks. It's about how I hold her. Yeah. So when she's having a hard day, okay, when she's had something go on, yeah, I understand. Like this thing says, lay down next to her, hear her out. Be with her, absolutely. But to say that it's commonplace and absolutely acceptable for the other stuff to go on day by day, slamming doors, holding someone's heart ransom.
Nasty words.
Yes, swallowing
nasty words.
Man, you're not long for that relationship. You know, and if you can't, you drag it on, you hold both of you prisoner.
And the thing is that a relationship is one person, whoever the person is who's not behaving nicely, they're like a spy behind your enemy line. And they're planting little bombs in your emotions. But then that's times are good. And oh, but do we got to roll with the good and roll with the bad? I got news for all of you. Life's going to throw us enough bad shit. I don't need it from the man that I love. Because I got to deal with all that other stuff that I can't control and I can't see. So if you're planting bombs, there's no trust. The expression is you pat me on the back with one hand and you slap me on the face with the other.
Right.
Right? And who needs that?
Right.
As if we all don't have enough to contend with.
Right. There's an exercise that I do with a men's group that I'm part of. And it's called Appreciations and Resentments. So we have a chance at the end of our time together. Okay, it's usually by video. It's once a week. It's very cool. Hour and a half. And we're called the Thursday Nights.
K-N-I-G-H-T-S.
And at the end, it's appreciations or resentments for the other men on the call. And it's a time where everyone's silent except one man speaking. I have an appreciation. Okay, I appreciate you for, or I appreciate when you said this or did this, or the man that you are. Or I resent you for always cutting me off in the meeting. And the other man and the other men are just there to just listen, just bear witness. That's what it's about. So if you do have these things going on in a relationship, Do you really need counseling? Or do you just need a really honest discussion? If you hurt me with words or throwing shit at me or whatever, just whatever it is, that used to happen for both of us.
Yes.
That is a full stop. That is a deal breaker. And if it's not a deal breaker, it's time to retune the dials, because it's not okay. And especially when kids see it. My kids saw this, and I did everything that I could to just be like, can we take this in the other room? No, they need to see us fight. Fighting is healthy. Okay, maybe once, and if we can get to a resolution pretty well, in any relationship, there at least needs to be one adult present. Well, a lot of times,
I don't want to fight.
I would be triggered. Well, people, and again, you guys asking out there, well, fighting's healthy, isn't it? Isn't it good to fight? What are you fighting about?
I have fought enough in my lifetime in the past four decades with enough people. I will not fight with the person I'm supposed to love. Why should we be fighting? You're supposed to be on my team. I'm supposed to be on your team.
Of course, we can have a discussion, right? We can have a difference of opinion. But at the end of the day, am I really that pitted on my opinion about the way things need to go, that I need to hold a resentment to you that I don't address, or do the whole silent treatment, slam doors, plant little bombs, like you say, and for that person to say that this is commonplace
and that it's commitment. Oh, it's commitment.
That's someone that's in a really...
And that's a valued commitment. It's a valued commitment. They value the structure of that commitment. And they can have it. They can have that and my helping too. Because I won't play that game.
That person sounds like they're in a real sketchy relationship and really is just rationalizing, staying in there. Kudos to people that want to do that. Okay, for the kids or for the other person. Maybe they're disabled or they just can't... You know, they really need the support from the other person. It's got to go both ways. Yeah. They got to be good to you. They have to be good for you. So that's kind of behind the scenes of our relationship. And I'm glad that we're able to do this. A great song to kind of warm it up. Great Meatloaf story at the beginning.
The song makes more sense now.
Right? Paradise by the Dashboard Light. And then to have that person, it sounds like a woman's writing, but maybe not. There's a couple hearts in there and things like that, but maybe it was a man.
It hurts me to know that goes on, yet I know that it goes on because I experienced it. Oh my God, you've experienced it.
How many of you sent us stories
and phone calls and messages and Facebook, and it's everywhere. And I think it comes from, so now I'm going to say what again is true for me. After 35 years on the planet, I decided that was it. No more relationships. The only reason I believe that this has worked between you and I is because you were the first person I didn't get involved with over lust or attraction. I was not attracted to you. That was not even in the realm or the scope of any of it. And I vowed that I would never, ever be with a person in a committed relationship based on what they looked like or just seeing them and going, oh my God. Attraction, you know, the tractor beam of love. I decided that was no longer really, I was a terrible way to do things, excuse me. And you and I had such deep respect for each other, being friends.
That's right.
That we got to know each other over a course of years.
That's right.
And us being married happened in 2016. We're recently married, and people say to me, oh, you're just in the honeymoon phase.
It'll pass.
No way, man.
You have to be married 10, 15 years.
We're going to be in the honeymoon phase forever.
Yeah, and you can hear the people going, yeah, sure. You know what? Try us. Because we have the secret. The secret is that we have the deepest respect, and we know that the first sign that one of us is really not happy with something that the other one did, it is a conversation right there. Because if it doesn't happen there, it then becomes a toxin. It becomes a cancer in the relationship. So there's a lot of you guys out there that either survived or passed those relationships or are surviving relationships with these little, you know, toxins.
Caustic moments.
There's blood stains in the kitchen. There's blood stains in the bedroom. There's blood stains in the car, because those are the places that you were fighting. There's blood stains at the kitchen table. There's blood stains in the you know, there's yellow tape lines from where there's been fighting. And man, when it gets to that point, stop and really, really go for a walk, have a discussion about what you're feeling, and maybe counseling. Yes, maybe, but I haven't seen it work out as well as I think it should.
And I think part of it is when you're in those caustic relationships, I'll speak for myself. I certainly wasn't in the place in my life that I wanted to be, and neither was he or were they, because there was many disastrous relationships that I've been
in. You sound like it's like a Terminator movie or something.
Well, yeah, none of them have ended well.
Yeah, and hey, remember our theory from the other day? Would you like me to remind you? Okay, hang on, guys. Just hang on. Okay, we're back.
Thank you. We should have played some music like they do on Jeopardy.
Who can read lips? So, Kel had early experiences that were absolutely abusive. So when she did have a relationship eventually, as long as they weren't like that, a past abusive kind of monster, it was like, cool.
You're so nice.
You're so nice. So she wasn't able to see that calloused forehead moment.
Yeah, slow learner.
And then the next one is a little bit better or a little bit different. And she's like, cool. Wow, that's a little different. They don't do that. Wow, they're really nice. They bring something different. 37 years later. And I didn't have that experience. I just happened to marry somebody that was a bad match for me. And I pretended that it wasn't a bad match because it's just the way it went. And then kids came and it was my commitment to stay because I stayed for the kids. And that was my moment. Well,
but as we've realized, you and I, that all the past experiences that we've had were preparing us
perfectly
to be together.
Perfectly.
Preparing us for this. Preparing us for what we have, this life we have here, and that everything was practice and everyone was practice. And we're done practicing.
Yep. Absolutely. So, there you go.
Hopefully that was interesting. We'd love to know your thoughts.
Yeah. If you're still here, thank you so much.
Yeah.
We're, 42 minutes in, and I told you it was going to be juicy, didn't I? See your light up? Did you see that? Did I do that? Soft. All right, cool. So we're going to come back with some more. We'll come back with some prog. We're going to come back with some airbag. Yeah. You love airbag. I asked you. I said, pick a prog man. You said airbag. All right.
I love you.
I love you too. Oh, goodness. What was that kiss for? A kiss for, how about reality check? A kiss for reality checks. A kiss for,
and a kiss,
this life is precious.
A kiss for all of those that are getting it right.
Yeah.
And that includes friends.
Yeah.
If you look at your friends and they are not bringing out the best in you, there may be a little conversation you need to have with yourself about the life you really want to lead and how you want to create it.
It's never too late. Mm-mm. Be bold. Be brave. Use what you have, the opportunity that you have, to not acquiesce, to not just roll over, to not be a mule, to not be a whipping post.
And know that you have far more talents than you think you do.
Totally. Your life will start by ending something. Again, it's just a conversation. We're not giving you a step-by-step, okay?
No,
you're
going to
do what you're going to do, and we are not responsible. But at the same time, we just wanted to bring it. I wanted to bring it up because I thought it was great.
Everyone's experience is different. And
for the song,
nobody could execute my life. Sarah down the lane couldn't do all the things that I did and have the same outcome because everyone is so completely different. So just follow your heart.
Follow your heart.
And look twice before you cross the street.
Don't eat yellow snow, unless you like that sort of thing. Later.
Kiss me.
I did.
Kiss me again.
See you guys.
Bye.